हेलो, आई एम प्रतिभा जाधव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस. टुडे वील सी डिजिटल सिग्नेचर विच विल रिक्वायर फॉर द साइबर फॉरेंसिक्स पर्पज. नाउ दिस डिजी वॉट इज मीन बाय डिजिटल सिग्नेचर एंड वाई इट रिक्वायर्स? वॉट इज द मोटिवेशन बिहाइंड क्रिएटिंग द डिजिटल सिग्नेचर? हाउ इट वर्क्स? वॉट आर द एप्लीकेशंस? देन एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ द डिजिटल सिग्नेचर. That we will cover in this video. Now, digital signature, it is a mathematical scheme that is used to authenticate the sender of an electronic document. Now, it is not the signed document, means it will create some hashing function and some checksum value for the digital signature. So, when the cyber forensics are used for the any crime, then the cyber forensics lab, they need digital signature for authentication purpose. So whenever you got any case, so before that, the person who is claiming the crime, that person should have digital signature. Whenever seizing will be there, any proof or any case is going to seize any document, at that time also digital signature is needed. So this digital signature is nothing but an attachment to a piece of electronic information, so which represents the content of document and the identity of owner of that document uniquely. So identification, authentication, and integrity, these three features we will avail with the help of digital signature. Now, what is the motivation to provide authenticity, integrity, and non-repudiation? Authenticity means person is identically, it is authenticate. Integrity means do not have any modification between the document when it is going to share. And non-repudiation means sender should have the authenticate one, and he should accept that whatever document is seized, that is seized by that person. So avail the facility of the digital signature. To use internet as safe and secure medium for e-commerce and e-governance, this digital signature is also used. Now, what are the basic requirements of the digital signature? That is, two keys we are using. So this digital signature is known as the asymmetric algorithm, where two keys are used for the encryption and decryption. So when two keys are used, that keys are the private key and public key. Private key is one which is accessible only to the signer, means who is signing the document, that is known, that key is known by that person only. So it is used to generate the digital signature, which is then attached to the message. And the public key is made available to all those who receive signed messages from the sender. It is used for the verification of the received message. Now, when a digital signature is creating, at that time, digital certificate is issued by the subscriber. Now, this digital signature, this digital certificate is issued by the organization, government organizations. A subscriber of the private key and public key pair makes the public key available to all those who are intended to receive the signed messages from the subscriber. But in case of any dispute between the two sides, there must be some entity with the receiver which will allow the receiver of the message to prove that subscriber of the key pair sent the message. That is, non-repudiation should occur between the subscriber and receiver. This is the diagram of actual algorithm which is used in the digital signature. That is, when you are creating digital signature, that message will be encrypted using hash function, and whatever value is generating using this hash function, that will be message digest. And this message digest means the signature which is created using the private key. Now this signature will be received for the verification, and in the verification public key is used, because in generation we have used private key. Now in the verification we should use public key. Now after verification of the signature, again message digest will be calculating. Then at the time of generation and at the time of verification, message digest value is generating, it should be match. That is, the value at the time of generation and the value at the time of verification should be matched. If that both matches, means your digital signature is verified. Now how it is working practically? For example, there is a user A who is sending message and user B who is receiving the message. Now whenever user A is sending this message, first message will be encrypted using hash function. Then message digest algorithm will be applied, that digest value and private key will generate the encryption, and that will be sending to the receiver side. So message plus that encrypted signed digest value will be sending to the receiver. Then that will be received by the user B, and he will again calculate the message digest value. If it is matches with user A, then document is retrieved correctly and user A and user B both are authenticated one. Now where these digital signatures we are using, or we can apply, that is electronic mail, data storage, then fund transfers, software distribution, the smart cards where we are using bank transactions, ISDN, time stamp signature and blind signatures. Advantages of the digital signature, that is authentication, means identification of the person that signs the document. Integrity of data, every change will be detected. Non-repudiation, the author cannot deny, that is he has sent the message or he has received the message. Then elimination of the possibility committing fraud by an imposter. Disadvantages, there will be expiry of the digital signature, and digital signatures, both senders and recipients may have to buy the certificates. To work with digital certificates, senders and recipients have to buy verification software at cost. Thank you.